Welcome to Facts TV News, where everything is true.
Estimated 1 billion fix for Bull Bay flooding problem. It will cost approximately $1 billion to address the issue of flooding in Bull Bay, St. Andrew, when there is sustained heavy rainfall in the area. According to Member of Parliament Juliette Holness, two options have been assessed: relocating residents or doing river training on the Chalky River in the area, and the cost estimate for both are the same. The estimate for both relocation and fixing the river is looking close to 1 billion Jamaican dollars. I am waiting on the Works Minister, Mr. Warmington, who is taking it to Cabinet to assess where we go from here, Holness said, during a tour of sections of Bull Bay area during Sunday's rain associated with Tropical Storm Elsa. According to Holness, the residents will have to decide whether or not they will relocate, even though the residents are in danger of being flooded or washed away when there is persistent rain. Holness revealed that Albion in St. Thomas is presently being assessed for relocation of the residents. She also sought to manage their expectations. The area that we are looking at to relocate the individuals is actually Albion, St. Thomas, but relocation is going to be costly. Persons have asked, if they are relocated, will they be paid both for their houses and given a free house? The answer, I am sure, will be no. They have to be practical, but every effort is going to be made to ensure that they are safe, Holness stated. Many of the houses in the area are built without the requisite approval from the relevant authorities, and many are elaborate structures. Holness warned of the dangers of this practice. Once again, I would like to encourage residents. It is obvious that there are some places you would not live, and it doesn't make sense that even though we really want somewhere to live, that we decide to occupy space that we know put our lives at risk, she added. Biker killed in St. Anne crash, car driver on the run. Police are searching for a driver of a brown Toyota Corolla involved in a crash that left a motorcyclist dead in St. Anne on Monday. The deceased biker has not yet been identified. An officer on the scene reported that the motorcyclist was traveling towards Trelawney when the car, which was traveling in the opposite direction, struck the biker from his vehicle. The incident occurred shortly after 8:30 a.m. in the vicinity of Old Folly Road. Alleged eyewitnesses said the motorcyclist, believed to be in his 30s, unsuccessfully attempted to avoid the car as it sped towards him. The biker, who was clad in a brown t-shirt and a pair of shorts, according to the alleged eyewitnesses, was rushed to a nearby hospital by ambulance provided by the Naranda Bauxite Company. He later died. The driver of the Toyota Corolla fled the scene before officers arrived. Businesswoman charged with alleged role in St. Mary drive-by murder. A woman has been slapped with charges stemming from her alleged role in a recent drive-by shooting in Baskerville, St. Mary, that left a female teen dead and two other persons nursing injuries. LaToya Wilson, a 31-year-old businesswoman of Capture Land in Boscobel in the parish, has been charged with murder, conspiracy to murder, wounding with intent, and illegal possession of a firearm. The charges stemmed from the shooting death of 19-year-old Nicole Marshall of Capture Land in Boscobel. According to police sources, the shooting incident stemmed from an incident in which one of Marshall's close female relatives allegedly wounded a man during a dispute on Saturday, June 26. The female relative of Marshall was taken into police custody. Further reports are that Wilson allegedly pointed out Marshall to men who later went to Capture Land area to find the now deceased teen and other relatives of her. According to St. Mary Police, about 8:30 p.m. last Saturday, Marshall was among a group of persons in the community when a white motor car was driven up, from which two men alighted and opened gunfire, hitting three persons. The gunmen then fled the area in the car. The injured persons were assisted to hospital, where Marshall was pronounced dead and the others were treated. Police investigators are continuing their search for the suspected trigger men.
Please remember to subscribe, like, share, and click the notification bell for daily updates.